Why is it always so difficult for me to decide where to parties? Perhaps that's a typical problem for a woman. I can, and often do, stand in my closet for hours, just looking for the perfect attire. Just look at these dresses and beautifully embroidered costumes. All are only slightly worn without fading from the dim gas stage lighting. Still, to wear. This elegantly draped one was a hand-me-down from the famous Madame Vestris. I always pass on these creams, though. They look exquisite against my pale complexion and brunette hair, but I pass them by until I come across the dress I know my subconscious has been searching for. Ah, here it is. This is exactly what I need on a night like tonight. You see, tonight all of New York's leading actor managers are converging to converse politically about plays, and I assure you, each one will be sipping daintily from crimson-filled stemmed glasses until they can't walk anymore. Oh, it's beautiful, isn't it? This dress is expensively made. But it's the unusual red stain on the lap that I'm specifically relying on to be noticed tonight. I'm hoping the crowd will inquire about the blotches because, you see, it's actually quite a story. That evening last April in 1865, I stood in the dressing room, scrutinizing my elaborately framed image in the backstage mirror, observing every inch of the yellow and green satin dress customized for the show's run. The dress hung demurely on my frame and draped elegantly at the back. Adjusting the green roses in my chestnut hair, I went to wait in the stage right wing for my entrance. Peeking out from behind the heavy emerald velvet curtain and looking beyond the proscenium arch, the theater glittered under the gaslight of the crystal-laden chandelier that hung over the house, making the prominent women's jewelry sparkle. This was a benefit production of Tom Taylor's Our American Cousin, and almost all of the Ford's 1,700 seats were filled, except for the corner box, which hung exactly 12 feet above stage left. You see, I had been a performer for over a decade already, and by that time, I had acted in theaters all over Britain, America, and even Australia, so I was not at all concerned with the number of people in the audience, nor did I have the novice's anxiety about remembering lines. Rather, my heart was beating particularly fast that evening because the theater was anticipating a special guest. He arrived about 10 minutes into the production. The play was stopped and the orchestra launched into a symphonic hail to the chief as President Lincoln, yes, Lincoln, and his wife, Mary Todd, entered to roaring applause. Ready to impress and checking my hair one final time, I stepped onto the stage. It happened when Harry Hawk, playing Asa Trenchard, was left alone center stage. Looking after the departed Mrs. Mount Chessington, he said in character,
"Don't know the good manners of society, eh? Well, I guess I know enough to turn you inside out. Oh, yeah? You sockdologizing old man trap."
Masked under the veiling laughter of over 1,000 people, I could hear a sharp sound that I knew did not belong in the cacophony. Harry exited the stage, and I could see he was content with his delivery of what critics called the funniest line in the play, when piercing screams drew my attention to the foot of the presidential box. There, limping onto the stage, was a familiar face. John. I knew that neither he nor his brother were supposed to be at the theater that night, but the booths were always in the Ford, even when they weren't performing, so it wasn't his being there that caught me off guard, but rather what was in his hand. John staggered onto the stage, holding a silver dagger high above his head in blatant triumph. And through the audience's screams and the blood rushing to my ears, I could still hear him yell, "The South is avenged!" I, knowing that this was not at all a part of the production, could only stand paralyzed, trying to peel my eyes away from the blood-soaked knife in Edwin's brother's hand. The gas lighting glinted eerily from the blade. But whose blood was that falling from the blade to the Ford stage? "Stop that man!" a stentorian voice yelled from the presidential box over the clamor. John ran past me in a blur, brushing the brim of my hoop skirt and returning me to reality. need a pitcher of water, I yelled to the nearest stagehand and began to run. Grabbing a fistful of my yellow and green satin dress, I curved behind the stage to ascend the squeaky wooden steps to the presidential box. I reached the door and pleaded for entry, challenging anyone to prevent the leading actress from entering to see the president. I swooped past Mary Todd and dropped to my knees before the esteemed man, asking the doctors who began to enter if I could hold him. Gently, I lifted the head and placed it on my lap, stroking the coarse hair and finding the bullet's entrance at the bottom of the skull. I traced the powder burn with slimy scarlet fingers. All the meanwhile, his hat lay sadly to the side, tipped over in a dejected bow. Sitting there, we were an unmistakable piatta being worshipped by the dozens of pairs of eyes in the box. The pitcher of water was brought to me along with a cloth, and I vainly began to wipe the blood from the face and neck. Large drops of red and brown fell onto my skirt like autumnal leaves, seeping into the fabric to create large red flowers on my expensive and custom gown. I sat there with him on my lap until they forced me to let go so that I could take him away. Though a horrific moment, it had its positive effect on my career. Being a previously known actress, it's hard to admit it when you gauge your fame is declining, but because of that evening, I was in newspapers. Everyone was talking about me. This stained satin dress, it's my souvenir. It ensures my place in history. Lincoln's blood on my dress. And now everyone knows about me. Not because of all I've done. Not because I was the first female actor-manager in America. But because I was the serendipitous British actress who happened to be performing at the Ford the night President Lincoln was assassinated. They told me I should throw this dress away, but I could never. You see, it's quite the conversation starter when I attend parties. It's a symbol of my fame. So. What do you think?